Hi, this is Mark from Excel Off the Grid. If this is your first time here and you want to take your Excel skills to the next level, then start right now by subscribing and getting notifications so that you don't miss a single video. In this video, we'll be looking at how we can use Power Query to split a single cell into separate rows. If you want to work through the examples with me, you can download the example file. You'll find the link below in the descriptions box. Okay, let's get started. Here's our source data. The data contains a list of employees along with any equipment that's been allocated to them by the company. Looking at Anna Watkins in row 3, we can see she has a laptop, an access card, a phone, and a home printer. And each piece of equipment is separated by a semicolon and a space. The attributes of each item are also recorded. For example, Anna Watkins' laptop has an ID number of ID011. And an access card with a number of 231, etc. The item is separated from its attribute by a colon and a space. And while this format is useful for quickly seeing all employees, it's not ideal if we want to know who has what specific item. For example, who has a company credit card, or who has which phone number? And it's this equipment column that we want to split into separate rows. Okay, so let's get this data into Power Query. To start with, select any cell in the table and then click Data from Table / Range. That will launch the Power Query editor. And here we can see that all of our data is now loaded into Power Query. So click the Equipment column, then from the Home menu, select Split Column by Delimiter. This will open up the Split Column by Delimiter dialog box. Now here in the drop-down, what you can see is that we have a number of predefined options. Now what we need is a semicolon followed by a space, which is not in that list. So we'll go down and click Custom. Then in the box below that, we'll enter a semicolon followed by a space. We want to split at each occurrence of the semicolon on the space. So we want the last option, which is each occurrence of the delimiter. Next, we'll expand the Advanced Options section and click Rows. And finally, we can click OK. This is what our data now looks like. We can see that each piece of equipment has been separated into separate rows. But we're not finished because we want to separate our equipment from its attribute. So we're going to go to Split Column by Delimiter again. And in the drop-down box, again, we're going to select Custom because we want to separate by a colon and a space. We still want to split at each occurrence of the delimiter. And then we're going to click OK. There we go, our equipment and our equipment attribute have now been separated into different columns. So let's just rename those headings to equipment and equipment attribute. And we're done. We're now ready to push our data back into Excel. So we can click close, close and load to. Now in this example, I'm going to load back to the worksheet. So I'm going to click table, existing worksheet, select cell E1, and then click OK. Fantastic, there we have it. We've now managed to separate our cells into individual rows. Now this is a much more usable format for creating a telephone list or for seeing who has what equipment. And all of this is possible because of Power Query. In the past, if we had hundreds of rows, this kind of transformation could have taken us hours. But with Power Query, all it takes is a few clicks. Okay, that's everything from me today. If you liked this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment. And I'll catch you next time.